Welcome to Monday Night Raw.
The line for the arena was around the block earlier. I'm surprised Saxton even got in.
Hey, I've got my ways.
The following contest is an Elimination Chamber match and is for the WCW World Heavyweight Championship. Making his way to the ring, representing the Triangle of Terror from Brooklyn, New York, weighing in at 232 pounds, Warlord.
Take six of WWE's hungriest stars, add tons of unforgiving steel, and remove all the rules. That is why Elimination Chamber is so devastating.
Byron, given how daring he's been of late, there's almost no telling what he'll do here tonight.
And that's what's so exciting about watching him compete. He's just so unpredictable. You never know what he'll pull out of his back pocket next.
Gentlemen, I think a fight's about to break out.
And his opponents, first, from Budapest, Hungary, weighing in at 580 pounds, Saturn.
There's only going to be one winner tonight, but my hat is off to every competitor brave enough to even consider entering the Elimination Chamber.
Well, the good news for him, guys, is that he's so egotistical that he likely doesn't even realize how these people feel about him.
No kidding, Michael. Talk about living in your own little world. It must be nice to be convinced that you're the absolute best there is, period.
WWE Universe. Universe, behold the leader of the Ministry of Darkness.
It's almost as if The Undertaker has commanded a cult-like following backstage.
And from Death Valley, weighing in at 330 pounds, The Undertaker!
Gentlemen, I wouldn't wish the pain of this structure on my worst enemy. Trust me, I've seen a few of them in this match before.
The third man has arrived.
The undisputed leader of the New World Order.
And representing the NWO from Hollywood, California, weighing in at 302 pounds, Hollywood Hogan.
This man changed sports entertainment history on July 7th, 1996.
Oh, that night broke my heart. Hulk Hogan turned his back on WCW, his Hulkamaniacs, and all of his allies to form the New World Order.
Here comes the Mastodon.
And representing the Eliminators from the Rocky Mountains, weighing in at 450 pounds, the man they call Vader.
This sadistic brainchild of Eric Bischoff has determined champions, set WrestleMania main events, and settled a lot of grudges.
Yeah, now we're talking.
And from Budapest, Hungary, weighing in at 331 pounds, the Devil.
I can't imagine what it must be like locked inside the unforgiving structure.
Yeah, whoa!
Oh, get up!
Byron, would you agree that he's about as conceited as a guy as we've seen in a long time?
I would absolutely agree with you, Michael. But he's also one of the most talented. I think that gets lost sometimes in the enormity that is his ego. One of the things I love about Elimination Chamber is that it's a different match every few minutes. When another pod opens and another superstar enters the mix.
If I'm starting the match, I'm trying to inflict as much punishment.